it.
Big McPanky's from McSpanky.
You fucking point guard! And you know it's me, nigga! You know it's me! And you don't feed me! Bro!
Yo, yo.
Bop, bop, bop to the top. Bop, bop, do them up. Yes,
sir. Like 27 in high school. How old is everyone was when he did that movie? Nah, I'm trying. I'm gonna try more a defensive build that can shoot. I'm gonna go with the elite Felician. Well, how you thinking about though? Yo, why can't boom?
You told me your problem.
So now I'm about to show Mel. Hey, you know what I'm saying? 2K24. I'm gonna show you on 2K20 because I don't got 2K24. Pretty much, as you know, 2K24 is so like a Kobe build, which means that Kobe builds probably both pretty strong, but eventually they're gonna everybody have a close back. Now, build that is very rare and uncommonly used, meaning that it's less likely to get nerfed and actually more likely to get buffed because what most people try to do is continue to make demigods because we're so addicted to 2K16 because of the gratification and the satisfaction that we got from 2K16 that we don't realize that we actually have a good game in front of us with 2K23 is they try to make a larger, bigger build who could do everything. But realistically, you should be going for a smaller point guard with a little bit of height to him because that way you will really actually be able to do anything. So I would say the perfect height around in 2K24 would probably be 6'5". Of course, if everybody sees this build, they're gonna nerf it, which means that, you know, it'd be no point in even trying to build. But I doubt a lot of people see this video. You probably want to go a little bit for just one up on the normal ring, the first wingspan, just one up. You know what I'm saying? just one, whatever the fuck that is, wingspan up from the normal wingspan, just to have, you know, a little bit of better defense. If you want to go for more of a shooting, athletic type of build, you could go for the compact or slight. Slight is more like a good finishing type of build and could shoot really well. Compact is more finishing, shoot really well. And it also depends on your height. Also, like, if you're a larger person that's compact, you'll probably be able to shoot mid-ranges better. But your three kind of gets slightly affected because you don't have the strength to really shoot a three. So if you want to have a character who is, like, you know, somebody who could do everything or be exactly what you want, like, which, like, before I even, you know, go on, the point of this build is to be more of an athletic type of build that could still shoot and play defense. But either way, you would want to go with a more solid type of build, or you could go for, like, maybe a little bit skinnier if you want to, you know, test the waters. But I would go, like, for solid, because then that way you still have enough strength to get, like, you know, your athletics and get finishes and get shots off, you know, effectively. What people usually go to when they first come, so on the next thing, what people usually go to when they go to the next side of the builder, they start off with like 3-point shooting when, realistically, that's not the point of this build. If it's more of an athletic build, I would say you should work on your physicals. So, of course, I'm going to upgrade the vertical to a 80. I would say an 83. But just to make it OP. And, of course, the driving dunk upgrades. But what you have to realize is that you have to work on your physicals correctly. And whatever is the first attribute you upgrade, that's going to be one of your most powerful attributes. So around like the fifth or third attribute, that's when you could upgrade your three-point shot, because of course you need that, or you could switch it to perimeter defense and then do three-point shot after, or you know, vice versa, and do that however you want to do that. So if you're going for a more athletic build, you might want to give yourself stamina second, which of course you'll need like over 95 stamina. You can't have under 95 stamina. And then you could probably go for strength. We're like the basis of a player. This is the base of a player, right? So, you know what I'm saying? You start from the base and you build up. I would say, you know, I would touch my speed and acceleration, because it's important to have your speed and acceleration if you have like a faster player. So, probably let my speed go to like 85. I mean, my acceleration go to 85. Speed, of course, like, people are right about acceleration being more important because it gets you to the heightened speed quicker, but you still want to have a good amount of speed, or there's no point in having a higher acceleration. Like, they have to coincide and coexist, because of course people found out that acceleration was important, it seemed as if it was more important than speed, so they had to nerf acceleration and they buffed speed. So, you know, so nowadays they have to coincide. So if you would go for 85 to an 80, usually you might want to drop speed acceleration down one and upgrade speed one, and it'll you know, coexist a little bit better. So after your physicals, you could go to whatever part of your character you feel like is more important. And I would say with that, playmaking is obviously the second part of physicals, but also so is defense and rebounding, and shooting and finishing is just the scoring element, and that's less of physicals. So but one of my points to the player is to have a higher vertical. I might want to upgrade this to like 60 though, or I'll do 58. So I'll go for a driving dunk, and I'll try to put that to like what, an 84, and a driving layup. I won't have that high, because the point is to have an athletic build, and I want to put standing dunk pretty high, because that helps your vertical at the end of the day, and I want to make sure to have a higher defense, but also post control helps your footwork, which means it helps playmaking in a sense, which, like, if you notice when you make a center, their playmaking is very, their ball handle is very low because their post control is extended, and that's kind of their sense of playmaking. Because, like, I learned this from watching the Joe Knows video, when you upgrade your post control on the center, you could actually get a higher quick first step. Which of course they took that out the 2K24, but they still have some element of some sort of, like, you know what I'm saying, some form of quick first step. So I'll put post control probably a little bit under whatever this shit is called, and just I'll upgrade, you know, close shot a little bit to like a 70. And that'll be valid. But as you can see, I didn't even notice this, but close shot actually helps your shooting. So you might want to upgrade close shot a little bit higher than driving layup, since, you know, it's a basic element of the game, which I really didn't even notice. So I just learned that from this video. Now I get a little bit, you know, testy. I might want to just work on one thing at once, just to keep the build like a base build. You know what I'm saying? Just keep it simple and not kind of go all over the place. Of course, I'm going to upgrade interior defense or block, because that helps my vertical a lot better. Well, actually, block actually helps my vertical a little bit less. I think defensive rebounding is what makes my vertical, you know, more powerful. I might want to put this like 69, because I can't really go that high. And I'll put this at like 57, and I'll put my block pretty high relatively for like a smaller build. And then I want to work on interior defense before perimeter defense. No, I want to work on the steal, because steal is part of like lateral quickness, and all this plays a part in lateral quickness. And I want a pretty good, you know, defensive build this year. But the thing about 2K24 is that defense is actually easier, so there's not really a point to make a overpowered lock. because they made defense. They buffed defense, so you could go for a little bit less defense. But if they nerf defense later on in a year, and you don't have like a good amount of defense, then you know there's no point in making whack your character with whack defense. And I'll probably put interior to like 50, just to save on some points. Next, I'll probably work on ball handle. I'll probably upgrade like in a weird way, because I feel like it might make a little bit sense to upgrade in a way where it's like you're upgrading them all at once. Why? I don't know. It might just be a 2K Easter egg that we don't even realize, but this dead might work. It's just one of them superstitious things. Like, sports are very superstitious. So it might be just a superstition that I'm just going to follow. Which I doubt I get a high 3, being the fact that I am, upgraded this so well. But I might, lower the pass accuracy a little bit. That's a pretty good pass accuracy. And I don't need that much ball handle for a more athletic build. As long as I can, get the ball up off a three-pointer and shoot free throws a little bit, because you need a little bit of a free throw to shoot threes at all. Well, threes consistently. You see, I'll probably be able to go up to 81, and there might be something that I could downgrade, because I realize it's pretty OP athletically. So I might wanna upgrade the close shot, honestly. But I also want a little bit of a higher 3. But I can hit consistently with an 81. Shoot. Yeah, 85 perimeter defense is really, really good though. See, I'm worried more about the offense of the build. I think I have a pretty powerful, pretty to a point unstoppable offense, being that I have such a high speed for such a smaller, build. Like a 6'5 build. And it's really, let me see how many badges I got so far. We got 30, 50, 68, and then 76. I had a build where I had like 84 badges. I just feel like this is like a better build. The reason why my badges are so low though is because my physicals are so like amped, relatively to this build. Not relatively like a other build, like for a 6'5", large wingspan, and not really very weighty player. My physicals are so built that like my character's like faster than most players, and he has more stamina and just more offensive consistency, which is like a element of 2K that we don't really, notice too well. That the my player builder is not showing you every attribute on purpose, like just to make it more interesting, kind of make it a guessing game of what build you're making, which may sound retarded to some people, but I think it's pretty cool, honestly, from like a gameplay standpoint. But yeah, if I want to up my shooting, I could probably up my close shot. Let me see how high that goes. Just to 84. Man, what would I want to downgrade? See, this is where I always get stuck on builds, because I make a pretty good build, but it doesn't get me exactly what I want. And I want to have, like, a little bit better shooting. So I might be able to this helps a lot on my playmaking, actually. And Terry could go down to 48, but 50 is pretty OP for a 6'5 build, being the fact that I have such a high vertical. I might want to upgrade the block though. not really dumb, but that's just more of like a test, that, you know, taking a test and taking a chance on the build. If I upgrade speed with ball, it's automatically like an OP build. I'm getting to the lane every time. You know, I might want to go for a driving dunk. 85 is not hurting anybody, and I could upgrade strength. You know, finishing the lane. And upgrade the standing dunk. I'd rather upgrade the free throw. Get a little bit of a better shot. And like my weak point is obviously laying the ball up, you know, which is common in athletic builds. If you're making an athletic, like athletic players for some reason have trouble really finishing at the rim consistently, like finish pretty well, but like in terms of real life NBA, they finish pretty well, but for some reason they have like trouble finishing consistently at the rim. And they're pretty, you know, valid shooters, but like it's just their, you know, defense and their longevity that makes them, you know, better players. So as time goes by, as you know, in 2K, you get the chance to get more badges and shit. So the more you play with your player, the better an athletic player will be this year, because athletic players are the new meta. You gotta really work on your physicals, and you focus on those, because those are the parts that we really, you know, try to not really pay that much attention to. If I go up to, but that 85 driving dunk is just to like make the dunking OP. Let's see what badges we get. Like, if you want to really, you know, go crazy with the badges. What the fuck? If we want to go crazy with the badges. All right, so in terms of badges, you gotta build your badges, you know what I'm saying, based off of having, it's like building a house, bro. Like, the tier one badges have to be strong because it's the base of the house. The tier two badges have to be strong, but a little bit less strong as the tier two badges, because it's like building a tent, more like a pyramid. It's a pyramid scheme type shit. The tier one badge gotta be pretty good. You get a little bit less strength in the tier two badges and in tier three badges. So if you have like 30 bad badge points, you would probably want to put like 12 here. You probably put like 12, maybe like 10 here, and then you'll put like what? Then you'll put like 8 in the tier 3 badges, if you could get 8 there. But you have to build it like a house, bro, because tier 1 badges are really important elements. This, like, the tier 3 badges are just like the icing on top, like making your player like that unstoppable. Or like just like that much, just that little bit amount better than the average player. Which these are very powerful badges, but these are not the main badges you have to focus on, because these little badges build so much of your player that when you focus on them enough, they actually, like, I don't know, they just take your player to like some sort of next level. Being the fact that you could just work on the basics so well, and you got the Claymore badge, da, 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 da. So I'll probably say for the badge you want to go for, like, Aerial Wizard's always a genius badge. Drop step helps your strength. Drop step helps your strength. Back down Punisher helps your strength, which helps your finishing. Giant Slayer, you probably want that on like gold or silver. You never want to put that on Hall of Fame, because that's wasting too much on Giant Slayer. You probably want to go for Bro Touch is always a strong badge if you have layup timing on. But it's a little bit nerfed if you don't have layup timing on. So, of course, people go for Fearless Finisher, because that's a necessary badge, which they nerfed that badge. But Fast Twitch got buffed, because, you know, it doesn't get used as much. If you want to, and Acrobat is always going to be a good badge, because nobody really even switches up their layups as much. It just helps you. Like, nobody understands what Acrobat really does. It really just helps you in the air. Like, when you leave the ground, like, finishing a layup, or like your layup animations, it gives you better animations too. Like, there's a lot of animations that people don't unlock because they don't put their badges together correctly. Then, you know, tier 3 badges, you probably want to go either Limitless Takeoff or Post Roger if they still have that in the game. But yeah, this is a pretty, you know, base build. I know that for a 6'5", people might want, like, better three-point shooting. If you want to go for better three-point shooting, I'd probably say you could lower your acceleration one, vertical to one, vertical to 82, and you could probably go to 82. And, like, you know, you're already OP at shooting. But, like, I wouldn't really want to do this because it's more of a shooting build now. I want it to be more of like an athletic player. Because the close shot going up obviously going to make you shoot better. And, you know, I'm really focused on defense, physicals, and finishing. Because that's how you're going to win games easily, because you can score those 2 points very easily. Even though, you know, we all love to shoot, nobody's shooting over 80% in a 3 point. If you're lucky if you're shooting 50. Because I really don't see that many people shooting over 60. You know what I'm saying? There's that. And, yeah, bro. This is just the build I want to go with, bro. And this is the build I think that people should go with if they want the new meta. You know what I'm saying? Like, in terms of, like, not meta as in what everybody wants to make, but in terms of, like, the most powerful build. And the most effective build you can make. Because a short guy who could lock up a taller guy, and then he's faster than them and more athletic than them, there's no way that, you know, that he's really getting stopped compared to, you know, a big skinny guy. Especially if you know how to play the game. So if you know how to play the game, this build is just that much stronger. Which I don't go for limitless range because, like, limitless range gets buffed because it's just such a used, overused badge, which is weird, right? They overuse the badge, so they buff it. It's just a weird thing that 2K does, I guess. But spot of precision, I like to go for spot of precision because that's gonna give me easy shots and help me easily make shots. But like being the fact that this is a more athletic build, I might wanna go for maybe, you know, you got team badge boost, which would be pretty good with like an OP thing. But if you have whack teammates, there's no point in doing that. If you're looking to take over the game by yourself and not really pass the ball because you're playing with randoms, you don't really want team badge boost or any of this shit because it's not going to help you. You might want to go for advanced gathers or easy blow bots for sure. And then you go for spot of precision. And let's see what you get on the build. On the, you know what I'm saying? You're LaMelo. You know what I'm saying? They all pretty athletic players, inside out scorer, which is pretty valid. Rare build. If you don't like the shades, you know, I guess it's just like luck that I got pretty alright shades. You know, some people look at the shades and say, oh, NBA star's not there. It just means that this is a rare build, which means it's a less common build. I mean, it's less likely to get nerfed. So this build that you want to go with because of that. Yeah, bro, and that's build science, nigga. I don't really got that much to say, nigga. If you think the build whack, that's you, nigga. You know what I'm saying? Word. So I got a bunch of fucking builds, bro. I made a bunch of trash builds this year because I just wanted to sell this shit. Like this year I just tried to sell niggas. I was just trying to be trash. But now 2K24, I'm dead going crazy. I'm dead trying. Actually, I'm actually going to try now. Let me see. 3-level scorer. I just do a lot of build practice, bro. Just fucking around with the builder. Shit's simple. Either way, you know what I'm saying? Like the video, subscribe, all that shit. Dot, dot, dot. Whatever, whatever. Peace.